Good day, everyone. We're checking out the tropics now with J7409 on Monday, the 20th of August, 2018. You're looking at the satellite images now of Hurricane Lane. This is from the Hurricane Center in Honolulu, Hawaii. So I want you to take a good look at this right now. You can see the cone, a possibility where it's going. Looks like it may have changed just a tad from yesterday. Still, it's got it south of the islands. However, though, I've been doing my homework. I see three models that could possibly take it a little further to the north. So I want you to check this out now. This is the latest information and pictures from Hurricane Lane as it does approach the islands of Hawaii this morning. Will it hit? Will it make a direct impact? It's a little too early to tell yet. Two factors remain for it to have to happen. Now, as you can see on the tracking map itself, this is where it was last night. Still a major hurricane, should remain a major hurricane until tomorrow morning. It will be a major hurricane. Then by tomorrow evening around 8 p.m., it should drop down in intensity and be just a regular hurricane from a major hurricane. You can see how this has curved up just a little bit. It can go anywhere in here at this time. So let's check out and see what the folks in Hawaii are saying about it at their weather center. Now, the aircraft from the NOAA Aircraft Operations Center and the U.S. Air Force Reserve 53rd Weather Reconnaissance Squadron have been sampling Hurricane Lane this evening. Now, of course, it's night right now in Hawaii. This is the latest report as of last night that came in from Hawaii, and the data provided, these missions have been invaluable based on the satellite intensity estimates ranging from 87 to 102 knots and Lane's poor representation in satellite imagery. Now, we might have considered weakening the hurricane instead of the aircraft found peak flight levels and SFMR winds of 113 knots in the northwest quadrant. And in addition, a drop Sunday estimated the surface wind of 117 knots was also found in the northwest eyewall. And based on these aircraft observations, we have increased the initial intensity to 110 knots. Now, the initial motion for this advisory is 275, 12 knots. Now, Lane continues tracking westward along the southern flank of a large subtropical ridge. Now, there is still quite a bit of spread in the track guidance beyond 2 days on the individual models. You know how all these models work, okay? Now, the models handle the erosion of the western portion of the ridge differently. And due to the forecast and upper level trough digging down northwest of the main Hawaiian Islands later this week. Now, the latest forecast track through 48 hours is close to the previous forecast. However, due to the overwhelming evidence that the western end of the ridge will erode from day 3 through 5, we had to shift the track far to the right. Now, the latest forecast track remains to the right of the European model, which is far left of the GFS, the HWRF consensus models. Now, this is what you need to really look at. Now, shear wind of 10 to 15 knots is expected during the next 12 hours. As you saw on the chart, it is going to start to die down. After that, increasing vertical shear is expected to cause steady weakening, with Lane possibly becoming a tropical storm by day 5, as I showed you yesterday. Now, this intensity forecast closely follows the IVCN consensus guidance. Remember, that's one of my favorites that go with the TCVN. Now, due to the large uncertainty in the future track and intensity of Lane, all interest in the Hawaiian Islands should continue to monitor the future progress of the system. Based on the latest trends in the forecast, direct impacts on the islands cannot be ruled out. The latest trends in tropical cyclone wind speed probabilities also suggest that a tropical storm watch may be needed for some parts of the island chain earlier coming up this week, like later tonight and tomorrow. So far as watches and warnings right now, there are none. There are no coastal watches or warnings in effect. Hazards to land as of now is just the surf with large swells generated by land. It should impact the Hawaiian Islands this week. These swells will likely produce large and dangerous surf, as well as strong currents along some of the shorelines. And as you can see right here now, this will make it a little easier for everybody, but don't convert knots to miles per hour. The winds are 125. 125, okay? And it is moving at 14 miles per hour west, due west right now. So it's going to have to make a turn. Will it make it? Let's check something else out. Okay, as we come over and we check it out, and I have the TVCM model on here, which is the black line, and it has it not hitting anything. But what we have to look at, we do have some models that could take it up, as you can see, right on up. We have three of them. Now, as we come down here, we have this model right in here. Looks like it's going to start taking a turn around Wednesday, the 22nd. If so, it would bring it right up in this area. Then we have this model right up in here. Looks like it's going to start making a turn. This is around Friday, the 24th. It would bring it right up to the same area also. And then we have this model here, which looks like it's going to start making a turn around Thursday, the 23rd. So we've got Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday to see if these models are correct and the other models don't pan out. Okay, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, if it starts to make these turns, doesn't mean it's going to hit it, but it means that these models showing that it could hit it. And that's what we're going to have to watch very carefully. Other than that, it looks like it's going to keep getting a little bit more disorganized so far as the winds go, and when it is up here, it does turn into a tropical storm. I'll keep my eyes on it. Right now, it all depends on that trough. I don't think it will hit, but it depends on what the trough does. So I'll keep my eyes on it for you. Don't worry, and I'll bring you the latest information on Hurricane Lane. So far as the Atlantic goes, no tropical cyclone activity is expected during the next 48 hours, and it's also not expected in the next 5 days. What about the Eastern Pacific? Well, over in the Pacific, no tropical cyclones are expected to form during the next 5 days either. And we're going to end up the tropical update together. I'm looking at this at the first time with you right now. This is the European model, and it's towards the end of the month, Father. This is like on the 28th, Tuesday, just a little over a week from now. Yesterday, I showed you the system coming off. Let's see if it changes any. We will move around 9 a.m. for next Tuesday. What is it looking like? Looks like that little bit of vorticity is trying to start to twirl around just a hair. Now, we know this is way far out. Probably is going to change, so don't get upset. But we need to watch these things to see what happens. This is around 5 p.m. next Tuesday on the 28th. Still got that, it wants to, but don't know if it's going to. I think we've got this high coming up. It's looking like up here. It may do some stuff to it along with the high coming down this way, bringing some of dry air its way to make it disintegrate. So let's move on up now to around 11 p.m. on Tuesday. And yeah, it looks like it's trying to tear apart now. This tropical wave is trying to tear apart, bringing rain to the islands off the coast of Africa up here. Still trying, but it looks like it's getting tore up. So we'll go to Wednesday and see what it looks like. It's not going to give up. It's not going to give up with these pockets of convection of rain in it, still trying to have a little bit of vorticity, but not enough to do anything. Still just a tropical wave is all it is. And by late Wednesday, it's still trying. We still have these pockets of convection that are moving over to the islands over here. But it's just a wave, people. It's not a storm. We'll turn on right quickly and see if it has what the pressure is looking like. All right, we do have this high. We have a low pressure system, but we have a high pressure system up here. Okay, this low, that's why the little twirl, as I call it, is vorticity. The spin that is trying to make up is moved a little further north because the low is pulling it and this high is pushing the low down. So we're still going to wait and see what happens with this. Really too early to tell, if anything at all, so don't worry about it. But I'm keeping my eyes on it. Thank you so much for watching. If you haven't subscribed, you like to keep up with the weather like all of us here at Weather News with J7409, please subscribe, click the bell, and check off the email notification to make sure you get all the latest in weather news and forecasts, watches, warnings, and everything up to date on the tropical weather. Everybody, we want you to stay safe. I love all you guys. I thank all you guys for everything you do for me. And I hope everybody has a wonderful, great, blessed day and peace, love, and kindness to each of you. Thanks so much for watching.